something very special going on at the library. Why are all these people here? And what are all of these colorful signs out front? Guess what? There's something very special going on at the library this week. We are voting. All sorts of people have come down to the library to cast their vote because there is a very important election that's ending this week. Voting is something very special that we get to do as citizens because it's how we determine all sorts of things about our community. We get to determine what rules we want to have. We get to decide what people we want to be in certain positions of power. It's something very special and very important that we get to do. So today for our story time, we are going to practice voting so that when we finally get to vote when we're 18, we will know exactly how to do it. Are you ready? Let's go. Hands go up. Hands come down. I can turn myself around. I can stand on one shoe. I can listen, so can you. Let's sit down, I'll show you how. Story time is starting now. It's time for story time. Okay, it is time for our story time story. And our story this week is all about voting because it's a very special week for voting. And this year, we are voting for lots of different positions, but probably the most famous position is we are voting to see who is going to be the president for the next 4 years. Being president is a very important job because you have to make lots of important decisions that affect the whole country. So our story today is called Duck for President. Duck for President. Now, before I read my stories, I like to wonder. I like to wonder about my stories. So I'm looking at our story, Duck for President. Do you think we've ever had a duck as the president? I don't think that we have. I'm pretty sure all of our presidents have been people. So I'm looking at a story called Duck for President, and that tells me this is probably going to be a little bit of a silly story because we couldn't really elect a duck for president. So I know it's probably going to be a little bit silly, but he sure looks like he's running for president. So maybe this will be a serious story with a little bit of silliness. But let's find out in Duck for President. Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. He doesn't smell very good either. Yep, he's very, very dirty. The animals have chores to do too. The pigs clean under the beds. The cows weed the garden, the sheep sweep the barn, and Duck takes out the trash, mows the lawn, and grinds the coffee beans. So everybody on the farm has their chores that they have to do. At the end of each day, the pigs are covered in lint bunnies, the cows are covered in weeds, the sheep are covered in dust. And Duck is covered in tiny bits of grass and espresso beans. Yuck, running a farm sure is dirty work. Duck did not like to do chores. He did not like picking tiny bits of grass and espresso beans out of his feathers. "Why is Farmer Brown in charge anyway?" thought Duck. "What we need is an election." He made a sign and hung it up in the barn. "Farmer Brown must go. Farm election tomorrow." Uh-oh, they're going to vote to see who should run the farm. The next morning, Farmer Brown found a poster on his front door. "Vote Duck for a kinder, gentler farm." Farmer Brown was furious. He ran to the barn and found the animals registering to vote. For voter registration, voters must live on the farm, show a valid ID, and be at least this tall. But then the mice got together and protested the height requirements, so Duck crossed it off. They're all going to vote. Let's see who's winning. On election day, each of the animals filled out a ballot and placed it in the box. The vote was counted, and the results were posted on the barn wall. Farmer Brown got 6 votes, and Duck got 20 votes. Duck got a lot more votes than Farmer Brown did. Farmer Brown demanded a recount. One sticky ballot was found stuck to the bottom of a pig, so the new tally was 6 votes for Farmer Brown and 21 votes for Duck. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Duck won! Do you think Duck will do a good job at running the farm? Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. Ugh, running a farm is no fun at all, thought Duck. That night, Duck and his staff started working on Duck's campaign for governor. The governor is the position of the person who runs the whole state. Duck left Farmer Brown in charge and hit the campaign trail. He visited small town diners. He marched in parades. He went to town meetings. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. The vote was counted, and the results were posted in the local paper. Duck wins by a nose! Mrs. Governor lost to Duck by 1 vote. The governor demanded a recount. 2 sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of a plate of pancakes. So the new tally was Duck won by 3 votes. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Oh boy, now Duck is the governor and is in charge of the whole state. Running a state is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hairspray, ink stains, scotch tape, fingerprints, mayonnaise, and coffee stains. And he had a very bad headache. Ugh, running a state is no fun at all, thought Duck. That night, Duck and his staff started working on posters for the presidential election. So Duck is already in charge of the state. Now he wants to be in charge of the whole country. Duck left his staff in charge and hit the campaign trail. He kissed babies in local diners. He rode in parades. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. He even played the saxophone on late-night television. On election day, the voters filled out their ballots in booths all over the country. The vote was counted, and the results were announced on CNN. Decision America. Votes for Mr. President and votes for Duck. Duck defeats the president. The president demanded a recount. 10 sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of the vice president, so the new tally was Duck still defeats the president. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Running a country is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in face powder, paper cuts, staples, security badges, Secret Service agents, and coffee stains. And he had a very bad headache. Ugh, running a country is no fun at all, thought Duck. Oh no, he made it all the way to president, but I don't think he's having a very good time. Then Duck checked the help wanted ads. And in the paper it said, Duck needed. No experience necessary. Must be able to mow the lawn and grind coffee beans. Duck left the vice president in charge and headed back to the farm. At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is now covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. And Duck is working on his autobiography. Oh boy. So Duck didn't like his job on the farm very much. He decided he wanted to do bigger things. But once he got there, he decided he didn't really like that very much either. Oh well. It's probably a good thing that we can't vote for a duck for president. That wouldn't be the best job. But you know what? Voting is still very, very important. Because it's how we affect change in our communities and in our schools and even in the country. And today, we are going to get to practice our voting. We can't vote in a big election yet because you need to be 18 years old. But we can practice our voting so that when the time comes, you'll know exactly how to do it. So every week for Storytime, we do a Storytime song. But I'm not sure what song I want to do for Storytime. I could do The Wheels on the Bus, or I could do The Itsy Bitsy Spider. I love them both so much, and I don't know which one to choose. So I'm going to ask my friends to vote. They are going to pick which ones they want to do, and the song that wins the most votes is what we will do for our Storytime song. I think that sounds like a great idea. So let's see if I can round up some friends and we will vote on what song we should do for story time. Let's go.
It's about to pour down rain.
Hi, Mr. Will.
Hey.
We're voting on our story time song for next week.
Yeah.
So I want you to vote. Do you think we should sing The Wheels on the Bus or Itsy Bitsy Spider?
The Wheels on the Bus.
Okay, thank you. Hi, Mr. Turkey. We are practicing our voting for our Storytime song. If you had to choose between the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider, which song would you choose? I like school buses, so I choose the Wheels on the Bus. Okay, thank you.
Hi, Miss Michelle. For story time today, we're practicing voting, and we're voting on our story time song. So I need your vote. Should we sing the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider?
Ooh, I like them both. Let's do Wheels on the Bus.
Okay. Hi, Mr. Elephant. We're voting on our story time song, and I need you to vote. Could you choose between the Wheels on the Bus and the Itsy Bitsy Spider? I'm super big, and spiders are itsy bitsy, so they're fun to sing about. I choose the Itsy Bitsy Spider. Okay, thank you, Mr. Elephant. Hi, Miss Maggie.
What are you doing?
We are voting on what song we are going to sing for story time this week.
Oh.
So I need you to vote. We could sing the Wheels on the Bus, or we could sing the Itsy Bitsy Spider.
Oh, I vote spider.
Itsy Bitsy Spider? Okay, that's your vote.
The hands are the best.
Okay, thank you. Oh, Mr. Polar Bear, I need your help. I need your vote to decide what story time song I should do. Should I do the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider? I like the song, the Itsy Bitsy Spider. Okay, thank you, Mr. Polar Bear. Bye-bye! Hi, Miss Sharon. We're voting on our story time song. Should we sing the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider?
Itsy Bitsy Spider!
Okay, thank you.
Hi, Mrs. Fox. For story time today, we're practicing our voting with our story time song. You can choose between the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider. What song should we sing for story time?
Well, I just love chasing spiders in the field, so my vote is for the Itsy Bitsy Spider.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, which is a better look?
I don't care. They're not going to care either. They're like 3 years old. Hi, Miss Zena.
Hello, Miss Amy.
We are voting on our story time song because we're practicing voting. Should we sing the Wheels on the Bus or the Itsy Bitsy Spider?
Well, let's see. I think I like them both, so I'm a little torn. But if I had to choose, Miss Amy, I would choose the Wheels on the Bus. Because they indeed go round and round.
Okay, thank you.
Bye, thank you.
Bye. Okay, we've casted all of our votes, and the winner for our story time song today is the Itsy Bitsy Spider. Great job with voting! The most people voted for the Itsy Bitsy Spider, so that's what we're going to sing today for story time. So let's get our fingers ready and I will show you how to do the Itsy Bitsy Spider. First of all, we're going to need your two hands and your fingers. And your fingers are going to crawl up for the Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the water spout. But then, down came the rain and washed the spider out. Up came the sun and dried up all the rain. and the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again. Great job! You think you can do your finger play for the itsy bitsy spider? Here we go! Storytime. I hope you have a great week, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.